Hello and welcome to this video. Now we've had a few requests on how to paint the stained glass effect on an immolator. So in this video we're going to show you how to do that. Now the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the actual clear plastic in Minotaur and varnish. Now the reason for doing this, it will give something for the contrast paints to stick to without making it opaque. So we're going to start off by picking out all that stained glass effect, and we'll be using contrast paints for this. So I'm going to start off with Ironed in yellow. After that we'll use Blood Angel red. Then we'll use Magos Purple and then finish off with Griff Charger Grey. But first of all, let's start off with that Ironed in yellow. So I'm using a small layer brush for this. I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette just so I don't overload the brush too much. And then once I've got a nice point to my brush after spinning it around a little, we're ready to start applying. Now it's entirely up to you which sections you pick out, but I'm just going to be starting off on one side and making sure I keep it nice and symmetrical. So just work your way around. If you need to, just go back down and get some more contrast onto your brush. There we are, the Ironed in yellow now done. What we're going to do now is move on to picking out the central detail with Blood Angel's red, like so. Just take your time, work your way around, and leave around about 10-15 minutes for it to dry. With the Blood Angel red dry, we're now going to use Magos Purple. We're just going to apply this to the little fleur-de-lis sections just here. And take your time, try to avoid getting on the yellow. With the Magos Purple now dry, what I'm going to do now is pick out the majority of the rest of the actual glass panels using Griff Charger Grey. And I'll leave a lot of these little arch bits here actually just clear, but I'll pick out a few little bits in them. Take your time, and again, keep using that small layer brush. And there we are with the Griff Charger Grey now dry. What we're going to do now is move on to picking out the lead detailing that surrounds the stained glass. Now for this we'll be using Black Templar. I'm going to be using a small layer brush for this because a little bit of neatness is required. It will take a bit of time. So all I'm going to do is just apply a little bit like so. Make sure I get a nice point to my brush. That is super key. So once we've done that, we're ready to start applying that. So you've got a lot of details that obviously go all the way around the stained glass. So all I'm going to do is just start in the centre. And work my way around. Now you do have the detail in there that kind of almost acts as a border, but just take your time. And you want to do a couple of coats of this as well. So the first coat is really just to make sure you get the neatness, and then you can always do a second coat just on the top part. So take your time, work your way around all that stained glass like so. Now if you do find just splodge on some of the stained glass you've already painted, just quickly wash your brush, apply a lot of water to it, and then just pull that area. That should remove any of that actual paint that's applied to those colours you've already done. There we are with two coats of Black Templar now applied and dry. We're ready to move on to the next step, which is to highlight that with Iron Hand Steel. So I'm going to do this as a dry brush. So I'm going to get a small dry brush for this. Just going to load up my brush like so. Then all we're going to do is start rubbing that off as much as possible. Now the trick behind this is to remove as much pigment as possible, just leaving small traces still left on the bristles. So crisscrossing circular motions like that work really well. Then all I'm going to do is just make sure by just going onto a blank part like that, just see if there's still a bit, and there is. Then what we're going to then do, and then pull this up, and then we're going to start going. I'm going to start the actual detailing here, then work heavy on the actual main frame. So all I'm going to do is just gently move across like so. You can see it starts to pick out the actual lead detailing. And a nice little metallic hue like so. Now if I just tilt that downwards like so, you can see what I'm actually doing is I'm not putting too much pressure. I'm just gently tickling. So none of this is actually going to go on that glass that we've just spent ages painting. It's just picking out just the raised areas of that piping. Then for the actual side area, I'm just going to put a bit more pressure on and then just go back and forth. And I'll have to do a couple of coats of this just to build that silver up. And there we are with that dry brushing now done. You can see it's really helped pick out that lead detailing with very little effort. Now to see what that looks like in conjunction to the rest of the vehicle, I've got one I prepared earlier with a few little extra details like the gold on the top picked out. But you can see it looks really nice in conjunction with the rest of the vehicle. Now this is just one example of painting stained glass effects. Just by swapping out a couple of those contrast colours, you can get some really interesting different combinations that will obviously match your personal collection. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own stained glass effects, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.